Hello, it's Jang here with a quick look at a LEGO DC superhero set. This is Batman. The Penguin Face-Off comes with 136 pieces, and depending upon where you live, this was released in either late 2013 or early 2014. The set comes with the exclusive dark blue-based scuba or wetsuit Batman, which is pretty cool. And I like the lighter blue color. It's actually a medium blue color in there. It might be azure, kind of changes its hue a little bit because it's printed against the dark blue. He has his flippers there, also has an air tank, just kind of helping to be part of his breathing apparatus, which would be partly built into his mask as well. But let's take that off. So there's the face that you see underneath, which is nothing particularly special or memorable to see for that. But this is memorable, the full face mask, the full scuba gear mask underneath. We'll have to take a look at that with the full normal hood on as well, but notice also the extra detailing that they have on the back of this torso. And there's what he looks like fully suited up with the other face. I guess you would consider this to be the primary face, and the one with the regular exposed face would kind of be the secondary one for this suit. The Penguin here gets a fur-lined coat. He's still got just a regular shirt and tie on underneath, but you can see he's trying to stay nice and warm up in the Arctic conditions. He's got his umbrella, and he's got a remote control unit, a radio to control his robot penguins, which we'll see in just a minute. Looking at this from the back, he's also got on the torso just a little continuation of the theme of the fur coat there with the dark brown, and no secondary face on the back of this. Now I do have the umbrella angled back a little bit, and that's because this guy is really front heavy. So if you have this forward with the radio up, also he's always gonna fall forward. You kind of have to balance this. If you want it to look fairly close, you kind of have to balance it like that, and it still kind of wants to lean forward. So I think it's probably best to either use the radio as a bit of a support for him, or always just connect him to a studded base of something. Batman gets this high-speed diver propulsion vehicle, which is able to travel, again, high speed, under the water or on top of the water. Has an interesting design to it, but I think it looks pretty cool and somewhat believable for the type of universe it's supposed to be in. This is a printed piece on the top, not a sticker, interestingly enough. These are flickfire missiles on the sides, so you can fire those off as torpedoes. I think it's the best way to look at those. And as you can see, the Batman himself is able to hold on to the handlebar with just one hand, which also allows him to hold on to a spear gun, so he can be shooting in any direction while he's operating this. And there's also a little spot back here with the two clips, which will hold on to the spear gun if he wants to hold on to the handlebar with both hands. You know, just a little different thing that you can do, but it's always good to have a place to place the minifigure accessory with one of these small sets. Penguin gets this rubber ducky boat, which also has flickfire missiles on it, one on either side, that kind of look like they would be in the position of feet there. Kind of goes with the color scheme. It's got a propeller which is kind of high up. Maybe this is supposed to sit really low in the water, so this would be a surface piercing propeller, or you could see it as just being an air screw, you know, something that's actually pushing air to propel the craft around. Either way, I think it can work out. Pretty good shaping with the rubber ducky shape there. You see it's got a little steering wheel for its control down in there, but here we've got Penguin, you know, with his umbrella and the remote control. So yeah, this one's not as interesting, I think, as the vehicle that the Batman gets, but I think it looks pretty good. I think it looks pretty appropriate, and it's a respectable build. Lastly, we get a piece of floating ice with the diamond on it that Penguin has stolen, that Batman is supposed to be trying to retrieve and recover. And then he's got his robot penguins here, which each have a big old bundle of dynamite, and they've got their radio control antennas sticking up. It's a fun looking little build. You can recognize what it's supposed to be, each one. So I appreciate really, really small builds, almost micros, like super mini builds that are recognizable. I think it's a pretty good one, but the little block of ice is kind of forgettable, of course. But overall, I feel like this is a really good value. I think that the price per part is right where it needs to be, and the fact that you get the, especially the exclusive Batman version, the Scuba Batman, I personally think adds a lot of extra value to this. So to be able to get this amount of stuff, just this volume of stuff, even beyond the price per part ratio, I think is good. So I'm pretty happy with it. And it's a really cheap way to get an official Batman. As far as I'm concerned, they can't make enough small, inexpensive sets like this with desirable figures in them. That's it for my look at this set. Please share your thoughts about it by leaving a quick little comment down below. Thank you for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.